download the installer. I'm going to download the latest version of PostgreSQL, which is 11.2, which is available for Windows 64-bit, but not available for Windows 32-bit. If you are on Windows 32, then go to download 10.7 version. I'll download this. It will start the downloading process of Postgres, but I already have this file, so I cancel it and go to this file, which is here. Double click it. Okay, then simply click next. Installation directory, I set this default. It will install the Postgres SQL Server pgadmin 4, which we are going to use for SQL query, and Stack Builder, which is used for installation of PostGIS, and command line tool like psql, which will sort the code. Simply click next. And data directory, I set this to default also. And you have to type the password. In my case, I type admin. You have to remember this for your Postgres database. Then click next. Port is 54332, which is default, and it also default locate. Okay, next, and next. Okay, and then click next. This may take 5 to 15 minutes, maybe, depending on your operating system. I will skip this process and do other thing. Okay, after completing this process, click this, which will automatically start the Stack Builder. If you don't find Stack Builder doesn't open this, then you can simply search here Stack Builder and then open it. The Stack Builder will help you to install the extension, PostGIS extension. For this, click next. And we need a special extension, PostGIS 2.5 version, and then click next. Click next again. Click next again. And agree the license. Click next. Destination. Click next. This may take some time depending on your operating system. Okay, it is open in my Chrome. This is the simple interface of pgadmin 4, which is very user friendly. This is our database. And keep the server. Okay, we have the default database, which is Postgres, and we have default schema, which is public, listed here. We have notable listed here, and we don't have the PostGIS extension for this database. To add extension PostGIS, you simply go to query tool, which is from here, and then type create extension PostGIS and run it. Run from here. Okay, query returns successfully. If you refresh your schemas and check the tables list, here is our own table, which is a special reference system table, which show the SRID of each coordinate system. To show its data, you can simply go to view data, or you can select a string from special Yes, yes, yes. And run it. Okay, this is a table which gives the SRID of different coordinate system, and simply we can add simple tables and simple spatial database. Such as, I'll create a table containing point and show this in here. Table demo ID is primary key, name is strict, and geometry field head geometry. Run this. Okay, finally run successfully. And I want to add some values on this table. For this, INSERT insert into demo my table name DLC geometry field. Values is name point and geometry ST geom from text point 1 1. Okay, run this. When it runs successfully, refresh here. You will see our demo table. You can see the data of demo table simply from here. Okay, here it is. I added a point which is listed here. We can show our geometry from geometry viewer. This is our point 1 1. Okay, in this way you can install and set simple query in your spatial database with PostGIS extension. This is my first video of database. Stay tuned for other videos and do subscribe my channel for latest update, and like my video. Thank you for watching.